Hey, what is up guys? Today I have a new video tutorial. I'll be going through the whole process of creating an icon. Let me just create a document called icon design and make sure that you have snap to pointer and snap to pixel deactivated. I personally don't like that. Make sure that you have smart guides activated just so everything snaps in place. I have this idea of creating a icon of a monitor or maybe of an iMac, but what's interesting about this tutorial is the style I've chosen. I want to have something very colorful and I want to play with the opacity and the blending mode of those elements. So first off, I just want to create something very basic. As I said, I want to have a monitor, so the first thing I need to do is to do just that. I'm going to be use the reflect tool you can find here, or you can just use O on the keyboard and select a point, and while maintaining the alt key press, you can create copies of the same element and reflect it. That way is very easy to create something that's symmetrical. So let me just make the weight of this stroke larger and select the fill to none. Now if you can't find the stroke panel, just go to view and you should find the stroke panel there, where you can have more control over those elements. Now I'm still trying to figure out what I want to do and how I want it to look. I know I want it to have rounded corners, but I'm not sure the weight of the stroke, how big should it be. You'll see in a couple of minutes why. Let me just remove that waypoint, and I want to have some kind of a wave in the middle of the display. So I've removed half of that, and again using the reflect tool, I just make sure that I have something that's the same. I group it. Now I want to join those anchors just to make sure that they're part of the same path, and now I can do my changes. The first thing I'm going to change are the rounded corners. So to do that, I simply select the direct selection tool and make sure I have my points that I want to round. Just holding down shift, I can select multiple points, and doing that I can round everything off. Now this is a bit too much, but it's a start. I still feel like I need to drag this top part up to have more of a just a more even look, because right now, even though it kind of makes sense for the display to be wide, but right now I just wanted to make it clear. So let me just adjust the stand again. I just select those points and you get a very smooth curved path. From time to time I like to duplicate these elements, and right now I'm trying to figure out where I'm going to place the end of these strokes. So I wanted to match the same position as the anchors beneath it. For some reason it doesn't snap in place. Usually when you have smart guides on, that's the whole purpose, to snap in place whenever you have two elements that are close to each other. Let me just add colors for each one just to make sure that every single element is well defined, and I can select it easier and make the difference between them. I want to bring this forward just because I want this main element to be constructed through two parts. So I'm going to select one half of the whole design using the direct selection tool, and just copy and paste it in front using Command C and Command F, this just pasted it in front. And now I want to do the same thing with the other half and just remove the remaining anchors. It will make sense soon, believe me. I just want to have certain elements overlap each other, but just slightly, and then using an opacity or a blending mode, I'll just create this interesting effect. Let me just duplicate everything, drag it here. Now I guess I can adjust this a bit and give it even more weight, even though it looks weird. please be patient with me. Let's go to object, expand these pads, and once I do that, let me just add some new colors, and not on the strokes, my bad. Okay, let me just select the fill and let's use an orange, a bright orange, some red and some blue. So pretty vibrant colors. I'm just using basic ones and making small adjustments. Now this can work with any combination of colors really. And just go to the transparency panel, you can find it there, window, transparency, and hit multiply. And this is kind of the effect I want to get, but I want it to be even more. I want you to see those points, like the points where they overlap. Right now, just because they're red with orange, you can't really tell. This is more like it. So let me just use red for that element. Even though it doesn't look great when red and orange overlap in this blending mode, I still think we can do something with it. Let's try something more towards yellow. That doesn't make really a change, but maybe having a different red. Let's check. Yeah, I like the way it looks on the right when it's on top of the blue, but not on the left. But that can be adjusted once you flatten the transparency, and you can have more control over those colors. I'm still trying to experiment with a couple of color combination, even though I'm kind of set on these ones. I still want to see how it will look with different colors placed elsewhere. Let's bring this to the front, and still you can't really tell on the left hand side, and that's what really bugs me. But honestly, the one in the middle that looks the best in my opinion. So let me just select, then holding down shift select everything else and move it out of the way, and this should be the final icon. Now select everything, go to object, and I want to flatten its transparency. As I said, I want to have control over the different elements. Let me just ungroup it and go to that particular element, because that's the only one I don't really like. So let's select the red and just get something darker, and now it looks way better than before. Of course, you can make changes to every single color, but in the end, I feel like this is a good looking one, so I'm just going to leave it the way it is. Even though it's kind of simple looking, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and these are a couple of more icons I created in the same style, just by creating outlines and using the multiply, transparency, blend mode. You can download all of these for free in the description. You can find the link there, and as always, don't hesitate to let me know if you have any questions, as I'd be more than happy to help. Okay, see ya!